Welcome to my engineering drawing playlist. Today I am going to discuss about concept of conic section for engineering curves. So in the last video we have discussed briefly about the different types of the engineering curves. Now we will see in detail about the first engineering group, that is conics. Here you can see, if you cut the cone with the different position of the cutting plane, then you will get the different shape. So here you can see hyperbola, then parabola, and then ellipse, and then circle. So here you can see also, in this figure also you can see, if you cut with the different position of the cutting plane, then you will get the different engineering curves. Now let's see, if you want to get the circle, then your section plane must be perpendicular to the axis of the cone. Here you can see. So here this section plane is perpendicular to this axis of the cone, then you will get the circle. Now next, for the ellipse, section plane through both the generators, here you can see. These are called as the generators. So the section plane must be passing through these both the generators and inclined to the axis of the cone. Here you can see. It is actually inclined to this axis of the cone. Next, parabola. Section plane parallel to the end generator. So these are actually two end generators. Your cutting plane is parallel to one of the end generators. Here you can see this is parallel to these end generators. And so that you will get the parabola. Here once again it is inclined to the axis of the cone, but it is such a way that it is parallel to one of the end generators. Next, rectangular hyperbola. In this case, your section plane is exactly parallel to the axis of the cone. Here you can see this is parabola. So focus on this figure. This is ellipse, then parabola, and now it is hyperbola. Now here you can see section plane is parallel to the axis of the cone. Now in between these two cases, one more curve is there, that is called as the oblique hyperbola. That is in between these two cases, where section plane is inclined to the axis, but the section plane is in between these two. So here you can see the section plane is inclined to the axis of the cone. So here you can see initially section plane is in the horizontal position and at last section plane is in vertical position. So if you decrease this angle gradually, then you will get the different types of the engineering curves in the conic group. So this conclusion is very important for the objective type questions. Now here also you can see the different engineering curves with respect to the different position of the cutting plane. So initially it is the circle, then ellipse, then parabola, and at last hyperbola. So here you can see this is the circle with red color, then ellipse with yellow color, then green color represent as parabola, and at last hyperbola. So here you can see with the different position of the cutting plane, you will get the different engineering curves in the conics group, like parabola, circle, ellipse, and hyperbola. Here you can see, it is really very good animation to understand the different types of the engineering curves in the conics group. Next, here it is actually comparison of these three different engineering curves in the one figure. So try to understand once again the concept of the eccentricity. So eccentricity is the ratio of the distance of a moving point from the focus point to its distance from the directrix is known as the eccentricity. So once again, try to understand, this is called as the focus point and this is called as the directrix. Focus point is the fixed point, directrix is also fixed line. So with respect to focus point and directrix point, whatever it may be the distance of the moving point P are used to define the eccentricity. So once again, eccentricity is the ratio of the moving point P from the focus point to the directrix. Keep in mind, this distance is always perpendicular to this directrix. So in case of ellipse, eccentricity is always less than 1. And here also you can see PF is less than DP. That's why the eccentricity is less than 1. Because of eccentricity, E is equal to PF upon DP. So I am going to write over here, eccentricity E is equal to PF upon PD. In case of ellipse, PF is less than PD and that's why it is less than 1. In case of parabola, PF is equal to PD, that's why eccentricity is equal to 1. In case of hyperbola, PF is greater than PD, that's why it is greater than 1. So we can say for eccentricity is equal to 0, you will get the circle. Here you can see. For 0 to 1 eccentricity, then we will get ellipse. For eccentricity exactly equal to 1, you will get the parabola. If eccentricity is greater than 1, then you can say hyperbola. And at last, for eccentricity tends to infinite, or you can say infinite eccentricity, you will get the line. Here you can see a different engineering course sequence. So initially it is a circle, then eccentricity is gradually increasing, and at last it is vertical line for infinite eccentricity. So look at once again carefully. So look at once again carefully here, eccentricity is increasing gradually. What is the name of the curve for the eccentricity 2/3? Can you imagine, my dear friends? Write your answer in the comment box. Thanks, my dear friends, for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate it.